Hello and welcome to day four. And at this time we brought in reinforcements. So here you can see my Volvo backloader, my Bollinger Munktle. Slowly restored this over the last 5 years. And then my sorry excuse for a log trailer, but that's all I've got. And then of course the Landcruiser that's come to do all the work this morning. So the first thing we'll do is we'll set up ready to drag the logs up through this section here. Turn this around and then the first thing we'll do is get some equipment out and start hauling the logs from the beginning there. I've got a mixture of strops and straps from my loading video and then of course my all essential winch weight, and we've pretty much got everything I need. thankfully it's not 30 degrees today, it's 29.7, so it's a bit cooler. There you are, that's the first load out of there this morning. It's taken about 4 hours to put that on there. It's a long old job by yourself. There's easier and quicker ways of doing it, but none as cheap as this. And the Land Cruiser, well, that's not what I bought it for, and that's not what I turned it into. But it's just performed in every single task I've put it through, and for the last 4 years, that saved my bacon more times than I can recall. And it has hauled everything, and it's still hauling. So we obviously take as much care of it as we can in the forest, because the last thing I want to do is damage it in any way. But she has to work, and that's why we dragged her out of the barn. This is the exact reason we have to get this back. So on here there's a mixture of construction lumber and firewood. I mean, you can pretty much work out for yourself which is construction lumber and which is firewood. And that's probably the first load of, I don't know, I would guess 20 out of here. There we go, back in the yard, and then other than the mad dog, this is where we're gonna put them, and then they'll get sorted. Firewood go that way, and lumber will go the other side of there to the sawmill. So that's not very helpful really, because if we had to bring it back like this, I was gonna bring this back on the back of the tractor, but somewhere I've got a loony, here he is, somewhere I've got a loony dog and he had to come back with me. So we'll take that back over, and then we'll cut a load of short lengths of the tractor and then bring the tractor back, because I can't have the tractor in two places at once, because I can't. I think it was day one, unless I'd done a preview, when I talked about the little road around the side and it was virtually impossible to see. Well, of course, you couldn't even see this behemoth from this direction. But anyway, now we've been up and down it a few times. You can see there was a little road. It's too wide for the Toyota, too narrow for the Toyota, really. But we're definitely opening it up. It looks more like a road than it does. In a way, I wish I'd done away with that, but it's just, yeah, it's old. So you can see now the little road track path that used to come down the side here. Would have been wide enough for a horse and carriage or a very small tractor. And then what we're going to do, since the trailer with all the logs on it has gone back, we're going to cut some firewood here, the width of the wheelbase on the loader, strap them onto the forks, and then drive this back so that we don't drive this back empty. Bit of a wasted trip if we cut them the width of the wheels there, stack them on and strap them up. That's that big one there is obviously not firewood, but even the birch is quite nice. Anyhow, that's what we're going to do. And it's raining. How lovely is that? It's just what the doctor ordered. Oh, the mosquitoes are driving me mad. Wow. We run for cover. They're just well, that was a welcome relief from the heat. I've got to say, it's slowing down and it's brightening up. So, as forecast, maybe it's just a short shower. My word! And no mosquitoes. They'll all run for cover right just at the minute. So that's a good thing. So far we're going well. That's a bit of a showstopper at the moment. I hope that track's not too muddy. We wait till the rain stops and then carry on cutting this up, load the tractor and track on back to the yard and get that trailer unloaded and turn around and come back. Maybe we'll get two loads out of here today. I was hoping for three, but well, I don't know. I've got to go fishing, so maybe we'll do two loads and fishing. take this opportunity to explain something. So this might be normal if you had a tiny little log burner in a kitchen. We don't. We have a massive furnace in the cellar. You've seen it, how to make firewood. So we would never cut and split like this. We wouldn't do it. But we have to get it to dry faster. You just wouldn't split the little stuff. And even some of that, the really big ones would be split in half, but all the small ones would go in as they are. Well, the big ones here, they're going to have to go with the quarters to get them to dry faster, because in here this should be full to the top. This holds 75 cubic meters, this does, and this should be full, and we have 20 of those stillages which hold 1.5 meters, and all of those should be full. And what you see there and what you see here is all we've got. So at this stage of the year, we should have over 100 cubic metres stored and dried, and we have nothing. So there's the problem. Here he comes. You couldn't ride in the tractor, could you, son? No. Hey, you couldn't ride in the tractor. No. Good boy. Let's turn this off and go for a cup of coffee. Yeah. so that's not some bad lumber there. That one there might be a little small, but I can make a post out of that. And that one is kind of hard at the minute because I need lumber and I need firewood. But anyway, we'll keep that there. And then this is now, well, other than running out of fuel and not being bothered to mix them up when I've already got some over at site, that's firewood from today. So all in all, not a bad day. Not going to get in two trips. My idea of getting in three trips, well, I don't know where that come from, because I'm just finishing now after 9.5 hours. Is it an expensive way of getting firewood? I can afford the diesel and I've got the old machinery, so not really. And I get a bit of construction lumber as well. Anyway, that's the end of day 4, I think. Tomorrow's day 5. I'll see you then. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.